kababayan, ang pambansang awit ng Pilipinas.
Kayang mag-ibig, Diyos ang sinakalan, alam ng puso sa titik mo'y buhay. Upang hinirang, huyag ka ng magiting, sa mandulupin, di ka pasisigil, sa nagatang tutok sa simoy at sa langit ng pagraw, ay hinatang tulakawin sa pagkayang minamahal.
Pivotal matchup is set for our second game today as Juan Munti faces off against the San Pedro Pablo Escobets. Both teams are separated by only one game, and a game that separates the top 8 from the rest of the squads. A win tonight could very well be the momentum needed by either team as we head into the last stretch of elimination games here at the Pilipinas Super League President's Cups 2024 dito. Pinoy ang bida. We look at some players arriving earlier dito sa Paco Arena in Manila. And our match at hand nga, Juan Munti going up against the San Pedro Pablo Escobets, the second of our triple header here today. Magandang gabi po sa inyong lahat. Jaime Mendiar this time, joined by the Choco Duo, Coach Melo Navarro. Magandang gabi and long time no see.
Magandang gabi, Jaime. It's been a long time. It's a pleasure to cover this game with you. Sabi nga natin, important game for both these teams because ang panalo dito will really put them in a better position come playoff time.
And better position para malaman ng ating audience, nasan ba ang parehong koponan? Sabi nga natin kanina, just one win are separating both these teams. Juan Munti standing at 7-4 and San Pedro at 6-5. One win in this ball game would separate them, the middle of the standings, would put them in a better position heading into our playoffs. Tingnan muna natin previous game nitong Juan Munti and that performance against the Cam Norte Warriors. I covered that game and it came down the wire and 1-1, 76-75.
Well, it was really a test of character para dito sa Juan Munti. With 3 minutes and 33 left, they were still down by 10 points and they really found in them that the much needed effort and the breaks of the game para makuha yung panalo na yun, no? They shot 56% from the free throw line. Very crucial. And 9 out of 16 because it proved to be the game, the biggest factor towards the end game.
Speaking of factors, stringing some good games is Paolo Criminales para sa Juan Munti. Almost a double-double in that previous ballgame.
19 points and 8 rebounds para kaya Paolo Criminales, who shot 8 out of 15 from the field. He's very crucial in this team because he could play multiple positions, guard as well, different positions. Kaya naman yung kanya talagang contributions will be very much needed in today's game.
Speaking of guards, stepping up still for Juan Munti is Rusei Koga.
One of the veterans, no, para dito sa kapunan ng Juan Munti, Rusei Koga, scoring 15 points, 4 assists, 3 steals. He was able to knock down 3 three-pointers. That's really one of his specialties. And they're going to need more of that in this game if they want to secure that win.
Dito naman tayo sa kabila, of course, the San Pedro Pablo Escobets. Very even ang kanilang record heading into this matchup and coming off that big win against Novaliches.
It's all about consistency, no, para dito sa Pablo Escobets in that game. They shot well from the field, 41 out of 77. They also won the rebounding battle, 50-36. And most importantly, they were able to play a team game, having 28 assists in that ball game. And total domination ang nangyari in that game.
Speaking of players dominating in that previous victory, leading the way is Jomar Santos para dito sa San Pedro.
Well, we cannot talk about San Pedro without talking about itong si Jomar Santos, who had 23 points, 3 rebounds, and 9 out of 14 field goal shooting. And yung magiging crucial ngayon dito, the touches that he will get, if they'll be able to put him in those situations we're in, he'll be able to score.
Dito naman tayo sa veterano na kausap mo lang during pregame kanina, showing veteran composure, talking about Pari Liagas.
Well, itong si Pari Liagas, no, he was my teammate before and now it's fun covering him. Had 13 points, 7 rebounds on 6 out of 9 shooting. I'm very sure masayang masaya talaga yung mga taga Cavite City, no, because he is a native of Cavite City. And Pari Liagas right now showing us that age is just a number.
Age is not just a number indeed. Couple other players for both these teams that we'll take a closer look at in this particular matchup. Not just scorers, talking about John Cantimbuhan Jr. and Andrew Estrella.
It's going to be a battle of the guards para sa ating marquee matchup. Itong si John Cantimbuhan had 17 points, 2 rebounds, 6 assists, and 2 steals in their last assignment. Para naman sa kabilang panig, itong si Andoy Estrella had 14 points, 4 rebounds, 5 assists and 2 steals. It's not only about scoring for them, it's about leading their team and being the facilitator para sa kanilang koponan.
Talaga magiging decoy, no? That making sure that they are able to facilitate and keep their other teammates involved more than the scoring output that they could put up. So already excited to see both these players matching up heading into this game. So, of course, Cantimbuhan in that previous game nga, Coach Melo, that I covered against Cam Norte, decided to facilitate a little bit more. And baka yun din ang gawin yung main weapon in this game that we will see. Meanwhile, let's head over to Jess Constantino for a report. Jess?
Hi, man. Coach Melo, iisa nga lang yung goal ng ating two teams today, and that is to make it to the top 8 after the elimination round. For the San Pedro Pablo Escobets nga, they have to start winning daw to achieve that goal. However, nagiging challenge nga daw for them yung kanilang schedule dahil nga medyo sunod-sunod na yung kanilang games. Coach Nel added nga that he's happy with their current lineup with the addition of Lazada, Clark, Homo, and Ginitaran dahil mas naging competitive nga daw yung kanilang team, and he hope na mag-translate yon into today's game. For the One Monty naman, this is one of the most important games para sa kanila dahil ito nga daw yung magdidikta ng tempo at magdidikta ng positioning ng kanilang team. However, they will have their hands full today dahil wala si Mark Sarangay and Coy Alves today. Ang reminder lang ni Coach Vinci, sabayan nila yung Escobets, but hindi nila daw hayaan na ito yung magdikta ng tempo sa laro ngayon. Kaya simulan na natin yung Game 2 as I send it over to Andrew Perret for our team's first five.
A very pleasant evening to everyone here at the Paco Arena. This is the 2024 Pilipinas Super League President's Cup. Our second game features Muntinlupa versus San Pedro. Let us now meet the starters, beginning with your Juan Munti Sure Homes Realty. At center number 15, Michael Machon. At guard number 22, John Cantimbuhan. At forward number 26, Paolo Quimerales. The other forward number 32, Harold Arboleda. And a two guard number 55, Ryusei Koga. Head coach of Juan Munti Sure Homes Realty is Vince Salvador. Assistant coaches Jules Hidalgo, Mark Raymark Francis Oval, and Rene Reyes. Team owner is Drew Guevara. And now, let us welcome the starters for your San Pedro Pablo Escobets. At guard number 5, Marlon Monte. The other guard number 9, Darrell Carangian. At forward number 18, Andoy Estrella. The man in the middle, number 19, Jomar Santos. At forward number 40, Felix Lepregu. Head coach of the Pablo Escobets is Nel Parado. Assistant coaches, E.J. Devesa, Port Castañeda, Kevin Parado, Jun Lauchenko, Philip Salonga, and Anthony Battaglia. Team owners are Paolo Emilio and James Montagnani.
About to tip off in our second game this Tuesday, Juan Munti going up against San Pedro Pablo Escobets. Look at the starters for both squads. Koga, Cantimbuhan, Machon, Arboleda, and Quimenales will begin this ball game for Juan Munti. Samantalang for San Pedro, Carangian, Monte, Santos, Apreku, and Estrella rounds up their five. Very important ball game nga sa ating parehong koponan. As we look at our referees for this evening, Marquez, Pomar, and Cañete rounding up this very crucial ball game to get out of that mid guard for the guys in white and black.
So that's true. Ito ngang magkapitbahay na kupunan, no? Really try to battle it out and separate themselves from that middle of the pack.
As Monte attacks the basket strong, will be fouled. Gives us our first two free throws in this game. As Harold Arboleda disagreeing with that call, but nevertheless gets an early personal here with just 12 seconds in this ball game.
This is just a veteran move, no? Initiating the contact and making sure that he's going to get that call, and he caught a big fish right there. Harold Arboleda, one of the leaders itong one minute.
Well, maybe yun yung tema nga that you would want to capitalize on if you are Pablo Escobets. Dahil ano naman natin, Arboleda, one of the veterans nga here in Juan Monte that could set the tone early for his team.
Harold Arboleda could play multiple positions. He's used to playing the four position back when he was still playing for Perpetual. Pero he's a natural guard, kaya maganda dito. Once he gets that rebound, tuloy-tuloy na. He could already lead the break for his team.
Kailangan hanapin ng guardia. First 2 points, courtesy of Monte, hitting those two free throws. Skoga will try from outside. That short, Mashon gets an offensive rebound. Reset, ito ang timbuhan. Rejects the pick from Mashon. This time a foul will be called here against San Pedro naman.
You would see the backcourt combination itong Juan Monte. Really deadly. Both scorers, itong si Rusey Koga and itong si Kantimbuhan. That experience of Rusey combined with the energy naman itong si Kantimbuhan. Really, really deadly.
And kapag nag-click, no? Pareho. Itong players na to for Juan Monte. And definitely a tall task for anyone here in the PSL. Missing on the other end of the floor as Santos will try. Comes up short. Ito, right on cue, showing us what you just said. Harold Arboleda taking it coast to coast.
Harold Arboleda, right on cue. Talagang that's his game. Getting that rebound, leading the break, but that time decided to score that basketball. Usually, he dishes those assists.
Alain mong parang kakapaliwanag mo lang. And that's exactly what happened. As a first three-pointer here, courtesy of Karangian, makukuha ng San Pedro leading 5-2 in this game.
It's going to be a challenge for Kantimbuhan to fight over those screens, no? Dahil they're setting a lot of those.
You know, Kantimbuhan is more an offensive threat dito para sa Juan Monte. So kung matetesting mo siya, mapapagod mo siya dito sa defensive end, would be one of the factors if you are San Pedro. Skoga will try once again this time. Dials it from downtown.
And that's just beautiful basketball. Harold Arboleda attacking that paint, sucking that defense, and finding itong ang si Skoga on that corner.
Tied at 5 apiece, 8:08 remaining. High octane ng opensa for both these teams early in this game. Santos missed earlier, still unable to get that three-pointer down. Arboleda will lead it para sa Juan Monte. Gets it to Mashon, makes a move against Apreku. Koga, kick out to Arboleda. Fly-by move, three-pointer. Gets that to go. Back-to-back three-pointers para sa Juan Monte.
And that time around, reversal of roles. It was Rusey Koga who attacked that defense. And kita mo naman, the patience from Harold Arboleda.
Couple of conversions dito para sa Juan Monte. Let's see if that opens up naman yung loob para dito sa kanila. Bawi naman kaagad. Estrella joining the scoring party to the delight of this Paco Arena crowd.
Nakita naman natin, Ando Estrella. Yan talaga, that's his trademark. He's a competitor. And he would really not allow na masusutan mo siya. Babawi sa'yo.
Tied again. This time at 8. Kiminales goes to Arboleda. Kantimbuhan. It's 5 to shoot. Attacks the hoop. Finishes with the left.
What a finish. Mula dito kaya Kantimbuhan. Attacking to the right. Changing hands in mid-air and just fooling his defender that time.
Up by 2. It's Juan Monte. Monte drops it off. This time, Santos inside. Diyan na susubok itong kanilang big man.
That is just a textbook execution of that ball screen action. Great assist mula dito kay Monte.
Another deadlock. Mga both teams not allowing the other to create some separation. Kantimbuhan may ipit. As an offensive foul will be whistled against him. Great trap there, shown by San Pedro.
And that's a rare turnover mula dito kay Kantimbuhan. Stop, picked up his dribble. And that's just great pressure mula naman dito sa San Pedro.
Opportunity to take the lead para sa Pablo Escobet. Kisses off the glass, won't work para kay Estrella. Koga looks ahead, finds Arboleda. Looking for Masyon. Pass is deflected. Juan Monti arguing that it came off a black shirt. But our officials pretty sure that hit Masyon prior. Ball going out.
That was a good call.
5:50 remaining. Santos, susubok na naman. This time, gets that three-pointer after three tries. As a foul off the ball, signaled here by our officials. So that three-pointer will count.
I'm not sure what happened there, no, but nakita ko kanina pa si Paolo Quiminales. He's the aggressor in this game. Kanina, he had a bit of a contact with Santos. Ngayon naman, mukhang dito with Apreco.
Of course, Paolo Quiminales not one to back down with this veteran. So, as we take another look at that three-pointer, Apreco and Quiminales. Napakilala lang sa isa't isa.
So they were just jockeying for position in the process. Usually talaga, yung pangalawa, no? Yung talagang nahuhuli.
And you know, Apreco, leading rebounder here in our Pilipinas Super League. Definitely tough assignment for any big man. Try to keep him off the boards. The Preku has to sit down because of that foul. And we see Quiminales. Couple of free throws.
Yeah, this is something that Juan Monti could really take advantage of. No? Dahil nga, alam naman natin na Preku is a monster in the defensive end.
And your teammate, Barry Liagas, mapapaga siyang papalit dito for Pablo Escobets given that foul called against Apreco. So Apreco, 13 rebounds a game. Almost a double-double average here in our season so far. A little over 9 points as well. Quiminales unable to get that bounce on the second free throw. Able to trim the three-point lead down to now just two. Papalamig muna. Felix Apreco on the bench. Juan Monti now trailing 13-11. Masyon from the free throw line. Rattles out. Put back. Quiminales with a finish.
And that's what we're talking about. No? The value of having Apreco in the game. Nobody there to box out itong si Quiminales that time.
Another deadlock in this first quarter, now tied at 13. Monte trying to elude Arboleda. Ikot nila. Karangian for three. Off to the left. Kantimbuhan tracks it down. Leads the break. Finds a streaking Arboleda. Beautiful fake. Alanganin yung pasa. And this leads to a fast break opportunity here. Santos unable to finish. Monte, offensive rebound. Gets that two.
That was a wild sequence we saw there. Nonetheless, itong San Pedro able to score a basket in transition.
Up by two is Pablo Escobet, 15-13 with 4:57 remaining in the first.
The PSL President's Cup 2024 is brought to you by Dumper Party List, C Prime Business Financing Corporation, Converge FiberX, supported by Kalos PH Sportswear, MDC Sports, Finn Cotton, Healthy and Pure, official hydration partner, Top Cop Gentleman's Grooming. Prepare for battle, your healthy life. Japanese Style Clinic. Media partners, Fiber TV, Blast TV, and Bola.TV. Live at IBC 13.
Balik tayo dito sa Paco Arena in Manila. Take a look at the beautiful faces enjoying the action this evening. Juan Monti and San Pedro Pablo Escobets figuring on this duel. 15-13. There's 2 points separating these teams. Maagang high energy. Pinapakita ng parehong koponan and of course, this crowd. Kita mo naman. First quarter pa lang. Talagang ganadong-ganado na ang crowd dante dito sa Paco Arena.
Well, we have a good-sized crowd no, considering it's a weekday. So alam naman natin, they're really anticipating the games that we have tonight.
Juan Monti looking to break some momentum being slowly built here by by San Pedro. Skoga, gusto kang timbuhan. Eludes the defender, is unable to finish. Criminales though, short jumper. Ayaw pa rin. Monte tracks down that long rebound, gets it to Santos. Pass ahead to Karangian. Ooh, look at that move, escaping the defense of Koga.
What a move mula dito kay Karangian. Itong San Pedro so far has activated their running game and they're getting their points off of those quick attacks.
After a series of deadlocks, a bit of separation created here by San Pedro. 17-13, leading by 4. It's 4:08 left in the first. High in the sky play, but Koga unable to convert off that pass from Cantimbuhan. Monte spins inside. May ipit. Finds Liagas. Fishes for that foul. He'll head to the line for a couple.
And that's what you get from Pari Liagas. Really a force underneath. And there were already two white shirts at that time. Pero tingnan muna natin ito. That fast break attack, evading the defense. Karangian scoring once again on that transition.
You know he can do that. One of the main weapons of Pablo Escobets. And look at the fast break point so far. And two of those, nakakakita lamang natin. 6-0 in favor of San Pedro.
Well, that's very uncharacteristic para sa Juan Montino. They're usually the team who runs a lot and magandang game plan ang ginagawa dito ngayon ng San Pedro.
So, Liagas gets the bounce on the second, splits his charities. Lead up to 5 here para sa San Pedro, 18-13 as we see Ingles checking in, replacing Cantimbuhan and Koga. As while heading to the bench, seems Cantimbuhan had a few choice words.
But he was claiming that he got clipped, no, during his last drive, and he was really begging for that foul from our officials. And very Cantimbuhan, you just gotta stay in the game, you know. Dahil you're a scorer, you're a marked man. You really expect a lot of contact from your defenders.
Arboleda looking to create para sa Juan Monti. Goes behind the back. Kick out. Three-pointer. That will go para kay Balbuena. Kakapasok pa lamang. Instant offense for Juan Monte.
Less than 20 seconds on the floor, already contributing for his team. And that's one thing that they're gonna need more, no? Yung kanilang outside shooting.
Keeping it close. As are the guys in white cutting it down to 2. 18-16 as Liagas will be called for steps.
That was already good offense, but better defense that time. Talagang inabangan eh. They were really expecting that drop pass to Liagas.
Alam mo, gandang hanap na, no? Pero nakapwesto na si Pari Liagas. The interior defense of Juan Monti. And shutting that door down. Arboleda gets it to Ingles. Attack strong! Napasabit pa. Gets that foul from Estrella. We have a bonus free throw coming his way.
And I like that execution, you know. Weave going to that horns. Ito namang si Ingles, just putting enough English on that shot.
Just enough para makapasok. More importantly, tying this ball game once again and breaking another deadlock. No surprise kung anong team sinusuportahan. Mga fans na yun. 1-point lead here para sa Juan Monti. Standing at 7-4 this season so far. 6-5 naman para San Pedro. This battle between two mid-carders. Santos, naisahan siya ni Harold Arboleda in that instance. He will be called for an offensive foul.
That's just experience for you, no? Harold Arboleda. He was waiting for that contact. Sinalo niya yung unang dalawa. And tinanulit natin to. Inviting Santos to go for that bump. And Harold Arboleda, yung minensyon natin kanina, he could guard multiple positions this time around, showing us yung kanyang wizardry from the post.
First, ininda. Pangalawa, andun pa rin siya. Pangatlo, yun na. Binigyan niya na ng Harold Arboleda special. Santos, called for that foul. Opportunity to extend the lead now para sa Juan Monte. Sila naman may opportunity here to create some separation. Ingles, spin cycle, high off the glass, plus the foul and the stare down. Enough English na naman ba, Coach Melo?
You gotta love the swag mula dito kay Ingles. Isolation up top. Look at that, one-on-one. And yun nga, matindi dun. Yung impact, the instant impact that he brought in today's game. Already scoring 6 points
And off the bench, no, Balbuena and Ingles making an instant impact as San Pedro will talk it over.
The PSL President's Cup 2024 is brought to you by Dumper Party List, C Prime Business Financing Corporation, Converge FiberX, supported by Kalos PH Sportswear, MDC Sports, Finn Cotton,
Healthy and Pure, official hydration partner, Top Cop Gentleman's Grooming, Prepare for Battle, Your Healthy Life, Japanese Style Clinic,
media partners, Fiber TV, Blast TV, and Bola.TV,
live at IBC 13.
Two and a half remaining in our first quarter. Juan Munti now gaining the momentum after San Pedro led by four. So we take another look where these two teams are. 7-4 para sa Juan Munti and San Pedro. Not far behind at 6-5. Kaya sabi nga natin, Melo, during pregame, how important this particular matchup is to create some distance with the bottom teams of the league so far, and maybe put yourself in a better position heading into the playoffs.
And from this point on, every game matters for all the teams. So, dahil ayaw mo malaglag, especially dun sa last four slots.
So, Juan Munti causing that turnover. Ahead to Ingles for another two.
And he was even asking for a foul that time. At tinan mo itong si Balbuena and Ginitaran going at each other.
Karangian daw breaks the silence para sa Pablo Escobets.
And that's what I love about Karangian. No? He's matatawag mo talaga, the calm in the storm. Always there, very steady for his team.
No panic, no, despite that run made by Juan Munti from the corner. Hits another three-pointer para sa Juan Munti, joining the scoring fray.
Both these teams shooting well in this quarter. 57% for Muntinlupa, 11% for San Pedro.
Arboleda with that big block. Track down by Liagas. Baby J, that won't work. Criminales with a board.
Ito ngayon, Juan Munti will slow things down. Their half-court execution has been on point so far.
We see Pantimbuhan ready to check back in. Para sa Juan Munti, Ingles. He check, short on that jumper. Liagas tracks it down. Pablo Escobets, 7-point deficit, goes to the corner. Ginitaran with a three-pointer. So three-pointers working here for San Pedro after trailing by seven, now just down by four.
Specialty of the house for Rich Ginitaran, played for the CU Scorpions program.
Jimenez looking to work against Liagas. Spins baseline. And, traveling will be whistled against him. Hindi mausog si Pare Liagas in that instance.
Mahirap talaga, no? Because wide body itong si Pare Liagas, and Kiminales finding himself in a very uncomfortable situation that time.
Sa Homo, checking in as well para sa San Pedro. Balasa, parehong coaches dito. Definitely also strategic matchup for both these coaches trying to figure out each other.
And also in the game, itong si Alan Mangahas.
Off the ball, foul will be whistled here.
Ingles! Marshall, Ingles! Last night!
Mapapansin natin itong San Pedro. They're setting a lot of staggered screens, and it's a challenge for the guards para dito sa Juan Munti, because you really have to fight over those screens.
Talagang pisikalan. Maaga pa lang dito. Nine to work with para Ginitaran. Kick out. Liagas once again from outside. This time, gets that jumper to go.
But that's a shot that if you're Juan Munti, you could live with. You know, dahil nga 15 feet away from the basket, it's gonna be Pare Liagas. That's gonna be okay.
Pantimbuhan goes to Ingles. It's 4 seconds left in the quarter. Balbuena once again. Another three-pointer. With the bench of Juan Munti making a difference here in the first quarter. Three-point shooting waxing hot for the Whiteshirts, and they will be taking a five-point lead heading into the second quarter. So we take another look at that three-pointer. Ingles and Balbuena. Mukhang talaga may usapan sila. Helping Juan Munti build this five-point lead, 30-25.
The PSL President's Cup 2024 is brought to you by Dumper Party List, C Prime Business Financing Corporation,
Converge FiberX, supported by Kalos PH Sportswear, MDC Sports, Finn Cotton.
Healthy and Pure, official hydration partner, Top Cop Gentleman's Grooming. Prepare for battle, your healthy life, Japanese Style Clinic.
Media partners, Fiber TV, Blast TV, and Bola.TV.
Live at IBC 13.
Moments before we resume our second quarter, one munti. After that very close ball game, several deadlocks that we had in that first, creating this five-point cushion against San Pedro Pablo Escobets behind their bench scoring. And ang mga leading the way is Balbuena and Ingles, 8-6 to their names. Yung hugot dito for both these teams have spelled the difference kasi parang nag-balance lang yung mga starting five for both these teams.
Well, it was a slow start for Koga and Cantimbuhan. And with the entry, ito ang Ingles at Balbuena. Not really sparked no, the energy para dito sa one munti. At ang bench scoring natin ngayon, 17-6. And it was a good shooting performance para sa parehong kupunan. 61% for one munti and 56% naman para sa San Pedro.
Militaran will miss on that three-pointer. Masyon looking to create inside. Baby hook, ayaw. Liagas taps it to Ginitaran. Look at Balbuena hustling for that one, but San Pedro will keep it.
That's what you expect from your bench players, no? Talagang really giving their head coach a very good problem in this game.
Very good problem. I know coach ka rin, Melo, no? Yung mga gusto mo problema. Xavier, first time in this ball game as well. Ginitaran, thought about the three. Drive strong to the hoop. Finishing in traffic.
And we talked about the bench points, no? 17 nga para dito sa panig ng one munti. Only 6 for San Pedro. But what about that drive from Rich Ginitaran hanging in midair?
Showed out showed us the outside touch so far that time around. Yung aggression naman niya. Papakita. Nice pass by Cantimbuhan.
This was the drive from Rich Ginitaran initiating the contact. And you would see the upper body strength with that finish.
Ito mo naman yung focus, no? And it could have been an end one pa. But still, finishing despite that contact. Fade away para kay Cantimbuhan. Claiming he was hit. Holding on to his nose. As a foul here whistled. He's pointing to his nose. Talking about itong si Cantimbuhan.
He's had a slow start, ano, itong, si Cantimbuhan. They're playing very physical against him. And look at this defense from home, just sticking in front. Itong si Cantimbuhan putting his hand up. And very hard to call, you know, with that kind of defense.
So far, hindi pa nga nakiklik itong si Cantimbuhan para sa one munte. But despite that, three-point advantage para sa kanyang kupunan. Liagas to Javier. He attacks strong. Finger roll won't work. Rebound by Cantimbuhan. He has a 3-on-2. Matatawagan pa nga. Kind of felt that call was coming. Pushing off against Homo. Hindi na nga niya nakuha yung foul kanina. Double black eye. This time, an offensive foul be whistled against him.
Itong si Homo is known for his defense. And that time, he really gave his effort para maunahan itong si Cantimbuhan, not allow him na makabuelo. And in the process, that was a push off on him.
It's really sometimes all you could do against the offensive prowess of Cantimbuhan. And that time around, it was enough para matukso itong si Cantimbuhan to give that bit of an elbow and push off para sa ating officials to whistle that offensive foul.
And if you're a guard, no, itong the likes of Homo, sila yung parang nightmare for you, you know, because they could really pressure you full court. Parang hindi napapagod.
Especially if the assignment talaga for Homo is, you know, talagang Cantimbuhan all game long. Meanwhile, let's head over to Jess Constantino for a report. Jess?
Hi, me and Melo. During the timeout, it's a collaboration between the players and the coaches of San Pedro Pablo Escobets. Napansin nga nila na halos on the right side daw nakakascore itong one munti. Kaya ang bili ni Coach Nell, bring one munti on their weak side for a lower percentage shooting. Lastly nga, he encourages the players, especially Rich Ginitaran, to take a shot if he sees an opportunity. Gentlemen?
Thank you for the report. That was Jess Constantino, a third person of our panel. Speaking of Ginitaran, ine-egg on nga nila. to keep on shooting as we see Balbuena seems to be whistled here for a technical foul. To his surprise.
And if you're Juan Munti, you gotta control your emotion. You're playing a good game. They're still leading this ball game, and yung mga ganitong distractions, you know, could really give the other team the momentum.
Able to hit on that technical free throw though was Mangahas. Balbuena will take a breather, much needed one, I would say. Well, maganda nilalaro niya, but as you mentioned, bit of focus being lost here para sa Juan Munti. Still holding on to this 3-point advantage, 30-27. 8:09 remaining in our second. 14 fouls na Juan Munti dito, huh? Something that San Pedro could take advantage of. 3-pointer from Mangas rattles out. Ingles trying to elude Homo. Sidestepping his way inside. Off the glass is good. Ingles continuing his offensive onslaught now with 10.
And that's how you counter pressure defense. You just attack strong to the basket and stay focused with your game. And nakita naman natin Ingles successful that time against Parillagas.
Bawi naman Parillagas. Hindi magpapahuli rito on the other end of the floor. Parillagas so far with 5.
That's such a soft touch, ano? Mula dito kay Parillagas. And this frontcourt combination, parehong Red Warrior with Chris Xavier.
32-29, still a 3-point lead para sa Juan Munti. As Homo, this time, will be whistled for that personal. Trying to shadow Kantimbuhan. It's the first team foul para sa San Pedro. So we see Felix Apreku checking back in. Had to sit down early because of that unsportsmanlike foul. Cool off nga siya for 3 minutes. PSL's leading rebounder. Kantimbuhan. Goes to Ingles. Wide open. Able to get that 3 to go.
Great execution, but an even better box out mula dito sa San Pedro.
Mahas once again. This time attacks. Great read from Sarip. Able to get that block from behind.
Sarip just staying in front of Alan Mangahas. He's not called the snake for nothing. No, slithering through that defense, but yun nga, nasabayan siya. Na-timingan yung supalpal doon.
Hawakan sa buntot. Nasundan Mangahas in that instance. Homo. Ginitaran for 3. Short. Apreku offensive rebound. Almost a 3-point play. Have to earn it from the stripe.
And that's what they've been missing. Itong si Alex Apreku tracking down that rebound. Mahirap talaga siyang ano eh. No? I-check because iba yung malakas yung katawan mo. And it's another if you're using it to your advantage. Ito namang si Apreku nga always has that that nose to get the basketball. And nagiging problema talaga siya dito para sa mga bigs itong Juan Munti.
Not the tallest of players is Apreku, no, Coach Melo. But parang league's leading rebounder despite not being the biggest of players. Pero yung nose for the ball, as you said, talagang parang alam niya where that ball would go to after a miss.
Alam nating dalawa, ano? It's always not about height.
But sometimes talagang height, Melo eh. Lalo sa atin. Maybe in this league, I would say. Koga, siya naman ang assigned dito kay Homo. Kantimbuhan, we'll try from outside. Still, can't get himself going. But Kiminales gives him another opportunity. Bounces it to Ingles. Gets the ball back. Stolen. Maginitaran. Nice behind the back to escape the defense of Kantimbuhan. Lilipad against Arboleda. Ginitaran with a finish.
And that is why he's being urged to take more shots because he's capable.
Pawi naman ng tres dito. Ryusei Koga off balance. Jumping to the right. Still able to get that three-pointer down.
Ryusei Koga knocking down that three-pointer. And kita mo naman, every time he makes one, iba yung nadadalang energy sa kanilang upunan.
After San Pedro was able to take the lead briefly, binawi agad ng Juan Munti as Koga and Homo figuring on that scuffle. So officials signaled for an unsportsmanlike foul. Not sure sino ang salarin.
And I saw their Koga pointing to our officials. And he was hit above the shoulders. So tinan natin. battling for the rebound, swinging of elbows. Sa pwestuhan eh.
That was a good basket from Chris Javier. That battle inside. Actually, dalawa yung nagpwestuhan doon.
And from that angle, looks like yung kanang braso nitong si Homo. Ito. Matatawagan sila. Double foul.
I think a good call. No? Kasi both of the players naman nga was jockeying for the position.
Nothing out of the ordinary there. No, just a regular basketball play.
Tied once again at 35. 5 and 39 remaining in our first half of action. Arboleda goes to Ingles now. 7 to shoot para sa Juan Monte. Goes to the baseline. May ipit ni Apreco but still almost converted. Apreco with a board.
Better defense that time from San Pedro, forcing itong Juan Monte to play one-on-one.
Mangahas now. Looking for Javier inside. Pass a bit wayward, turnover. Para dito sa San Pedro.
Too risky that time, no? Was that pass from Alan Mangahas? He had a wide open shooter on the top of the key, but opted to thread the needle dun sa kanyang pasa from that roller.
Pagtimbuhan now. Tag strong. They rotate it to Arboleda. Nice fake. Too strong on that three. Apreco another board. Mangahas to Ginitaran. Can't get that three as well. Javier gives him another opportunity. Mangahas to Ginitaran. Thought about it. Drops it off. Homo able to get that basket underneath. Javier taps it to himself. Third opportunity para sa San Pedro. Stolen by Kantimbuhan. Uncontested. Gets that easiest basket para dito kay Kantimbuhan. You'll take it.
And a lot of opportunities right there for San Pedro, but it was a case of overpasing for them. And ito namang Juan Monte taking advantage. This is a 37-35 up Monte, up by two.
The PSL President's Cup 2024 is brought to you by Dumper Party List, C Prime Business Financing Corporation, Converge FiberX, supported by Kalos PH Sportswear, MDC Sports, Finn Cotton,
Healthy and Pure, official hydration partner, Top Cop Gentleman's Grooming. Prepare for battle, your healthy life, Japanese Style Clinic.
Media partners, Fiber TV, Blast TV, and Bola.TV.
Live at IBC 13.
37-35, Juan Monte with this slim two-point lead against San Pedro Pablo Escobets. Once again, take a look at the crowd here in Paco Arena in Manila. Supporting both these teams. Enjoying this evening's action on a Tuesday. Sabi mo nga, Melo, good-sized crowd. And that's the second of three games. Atin sa inyo ng ating Pilipinas Super League. SGA Blazers still going up against San Juan Kings to finish this Tuesday game day.
So this has turned out to be a quality game so far. No, both of our teams executing very well. Field goal shooting at a very high 51% right now, and 46 naman para sa San Pedro. So yung composure talaga, that's the thing that will separate both these teams.
Estrella Black back in the ball game para sa San Pedro. Goes to Javier, works inside, tying this ball game at 37.
And a lot of bodies falling there. Apreco and itong si Harold Arboleda. Talaga nandun yung kiskisan and on that rebounding battle sa pistuhan.
Would you like that the officials, no? Just trying to allow these players to be physical without necessarily, no, being dirty. They go to the block. Jimenez against Javier. Sport to work with. Trying to muscle his way through. Ball is tapped outside. A second to shoot para sa Juan Monte. Sarep returns in the ball game, replacing Ingles. Sarep was the hero in that victory against the Cam Norte Warriors at key end one, the end of that ball game. Arboleda loses it to Apreco. They have a 4-on-2. Javier takes it all the way.
Chris Xavier right there showing us that he could also play like a guard, no, faking that pass and opting to finish with his right.
Awkward ng pass break na yun, Melo. No? Preco led it for San Pedro and gave it to Chris Xavier for the finish.
Magwara dyan, nanood din.
Koga behind the back to Arboleda. Kick out, Kantimbuhan. He will try once again. Won't get a bounce. Sarip keeps it alive and will be fouled here by Javier.
And that's what you need from Sarip. Just trying to fight for that extra possession. And he was successful that time getting that foul from Chris Xavier.
I like how you put that, Melo. An extra possession in a game as important as this and as close as it has been so far in this first half. Extra possession na yun just might be the difference maker.
So far, rebounding battle natin. 15 for San Pedro, 14 naman para dito sa One Monte.
Apreco, another board. Karangian. Back in the ball game as well para sa Pablo Escobet. Looking inside for Javier. Basket won't count. Our official says foul is on the floor. But Juan Monti is long in the penalty. Kanina pa in the 8-minute mark of our second quarter. Kiminales will be whistled for that personal and will mean free throws here para San Pedro.
And I like that decision making from Janus Luzada. No? He was already open on the 3-point line. We know he's a shooter. Pero yun nga, nakita niya yung advantage underneath. Itong si Chris Xavier doing that rim run job. And napwestuhan niya na maganda-ganda doon si Kiminales.
Able to convert on that first. So the front line here of San Pedro really providing that difference here in the second. So yung bench ng Juan Monte naging susi in building that lead to end the first quarter. They led by 5:30-25 heading into our second. Ito namang San Pedro adjusting, going big with the Preco, Javier, and Viagas earlier. Medyo nang problema itong Juan Monte.
And they're playing good defense. They held itong Juan Monte to just 7 points here in the second quarter.
Pogan able to finish on that penetration. The foul will be whistled here against San Pedro. Javier with the second personal. And still not yet at the limit. Pablo Escobets. Derigue will check in. Replacing Chris Xavier, trying to nurse those two fouls.
And Chris Xavier had an exchange of words with our officials because he was trying to point out how physical the game is. And alam naman natin mga veterano, gusto rin maka-advantage konti niyan.
Arboleda. Goes to Sarip. Too strong on that layup. Kiminales tracks down that long board. Resets to Arboleda. He says, let's slow it down. Goes to the block. Machon, turn around, short. Bit of miscommunication there.
Yun ang masakit doon, ano, if you're San Pedro. It's hard to get a stop dahil nga multiple possessions ang nakukuha ngayon itong Juan Monte, and then you're just gonna throw the ball away just like that.
Sayang stop, no? And, momentum clearly on the side of Pablo Escobets. Now you're opening another opportunity here para sa Juan Monte. We see a player down. Machon holding on to his mouth. Their officials stopping the game, making sure that Machon is fully okay. And we see Lozada trying to apologize.
Looks like it was an incidental contact right there. Lozada was trying to, I guess he was trying to fight the screen and trying to go back to his man. Kita mo, he quickly apologized, you know, even though while the ball was still in play.
Siyempre, if you are the recipient of the contact, take another look.
Ayun. He was trying to get out of that jam, ano, and in the process, natamaan nga sa may bandang panga kung si Machon, eh, medyo hindi nga niya magugustuhan yan.
There wasn't a call initially on the play, but they had to stop the action since Machon was seen to be down.
And we have the benefit of reviewing plays like that right now, no? Dahil nga with the updated FIBA rules, they put yung another article there, yung tinatawag na possible act of violence. So pwede mo nang ma-review even without a call during the live game, mabibigyan na ng pagkakataon yung ating mga officials to spot and check those kinds of plays. Yung mga dati-rating posibleng nakakalusot. This time around, in the advance of technology na rin, syempre. Giving those types of replays. And fortunately, Lozada will be whistled for unsportsmanlike foul after review. So Machon will head to the line for an opportunity to bring this three-point lead down.
And not only that, this is an opportunity to once again bring the momentum back to your side para dito sa Juan Munti, because sabi nga natin, they've been slowed down by the defense of San Pedro after scoring 30 points in the first quarter. Ngayon, 7 points pa lamang kanilang naitatala. So this could be a start of something if you are Juan Munti.
Stop of play din, no? Yung tigil ng aksyon. Especially San Pedro scoring on several fast break opportunities and their attempt to break away, similar to what Juan Munti intended to do in the first quarter. As San Pedro still trying to make a case that it was an inadvertent contact by Janus Lozada.
He needs to be replaced right now. Mukhang yun ang pinag-uusapan ngayon dito.
So Machon waiting on the line. Still trying to figure out sino nga ang papalit dito kay Janus Lozada. Similar to Felix Apreco earlier. Has to sit down. And with the minute and 48 left in our first half, kikarry over yung 3 minutes na yan. Heading into the second. Oh.
That's big, no? Para dito sa San Pedro, because ito nga si Lozada could spread the floor, eh. Give his teammates more chance to penetrate the paint dahil nga you would have to close out long on him as he's a good shooter.
I think yun nga din talaga yung plano sana ng San Pedro dito to free up a bit more space for the likes of Apreco and even Chris Xavier, who unfortunately also had to sit down because of those two fouls. So sabi mo nga, Juan Munti would want to use this to their advantage, and with a minute and 48, get that momentum back. Still trailing by 2 though, 40-38. Koga goes to Sarip, puts it up, long on that 3.
Yung ngayon ang tanong for the side of Juan Munti, with kung sila kantimbuhan on the bench together with Ingles and Balbuena, sino ngayon ang pupuntahan in the offensive end?
Derige will miss on that 3-pointer.
Ito naman si Harold Arboleda, deciding to slow things down, calls play number 3. This is the same play earlier, ending up to that top ball screen.
Arboleda against Derige. The 7 to shoot. Goes to Jimenez. Jab step, pull up, gets that jumper to go. Impatience paying off para dito sa Juan Munti. Setting up itong si Pau Jimenez on that free throw area. And we all know, if you're a stretch forward, that's a perfect spot for you to operate.
Sweet spot, as they call it. Monte attacking strong. Able to get that layup to go. Derige gives them a second opportunity. Karangian wide open.
Can't get that three-pointer. It's a battle for that board. Apreco and Arboleda. San Pedro will keep it. So take another look. Excellent footwork. Jimenez. Smooth on that jumper.
Isang jab lang, eh, no? Just creating enough space para naman dito sa kabilang side, no? I do not want to be in the middle of that rebounding battle. Itong si Arboleda at si Apreco.
Monte once again. With the baseline, floater, short. Jimenez with a board. Went for that 2-for-1 was Monte. About 10-second shot clock and game clock difference. Arboleda directing traffic here para sa Juan Munti. Looking to attack. With the corner, Sarip. Three-pointer won't go. Apreco corrals the rebound as Karangian wisely slows it down. Looking to get the last shot. Attacking Koga. His shot won't go. Arboleda still 2 seconds. Heaves it up. That short
And as the theme of this game so far, Coach Melo, really both these teams sticking to each other, tied at 40. As we look at our super move of the game brought to us by Dumper.
This was that move of Rich Ginitaran hanging in midair, challenging the defense of Harold Arboleda and finishing with that left hand. Kita mo naman, showing us the handles. And a beautiful move right here from Rich Ginitaran.
Arboleda wise not to challenge that one. And at the end of our first half, tied at 40 is Juan Munti and San Pedro.
The PSL President's Cup 2024 is brought to you by Dumper Party List, C Prime Business Financing Corporation, Converge FiberX, supported by Kalos PH Sportswear, MDC Sports, Finn Cotton,
Healthy and Pure, official hydration partner, Top Cop Gentleman's Grooming, Prepare for Battle, Your Healthy Life, Japanese Style Clinic,
media partners, Fiber TV, Blast TV, and Bola.TV.
Live at IBC 13.
Hey, Hoop fans, welcome to the President's Cup 2024 Top 10 Plays of the Week. Let's dive straight into the action, starting with number 10.
Will attack two black shirts, goes all the way, plus the foul! Satisfies this ball game at 75 and an opportunity to get the lead back para sa Juan Munti. That's
Cesare could have waited for teammates, but he felt very confident seeing only Denzel Wong.
At number 9.
Set for this pick. Attacking the lane strong. Taiwan takes it on the other side.
You know, we've been talking about his playmaking all game long, but when it's time to score the points, Taiwan just scored the biggest bucket of the game.
Top 8.
Steal from Tau Tuan. Slow-mo! Nailangan lahat ng nasa sa Phil Oil Eco Oil Center.
That's what you call a 1-2-step.
Making it on 7.
Tulan defending. Daniela goes inside. Ooh. Oh, and a slam! By Paul Turco, showing no respect for human life.
Turco, bring the thunder early here.
Sliding into number 6.
Against Bamboy. Celes pops out, drives in, hits the basket, plus a foul.
You could see Baitiong there standing his ground, but the fact that Celes created an angle to not hit itong si Baitiong straight on.
Through at number 5.
With a running start. Oh, the bounce pass inside by Bamboy Raymundo.
And that's usually the kind of pass that Bamboy Raymundo dishes out, but that time being the recipient of that great pass from Kenny Rogers from a curva.
Cuts the lead down to 3. 2 minutes left here.
Cracking into the top 4.
This bench mob of Coach Boyd Fernandez really crucial. JJ Pido, basket and 1.
JJ Pido providing the offense really on the floor, usually to make the defensive stop, but that time.
Podium time at number 3.
5 seconds left. Susugod. Goes up. How did he get that shot up and in? Junji Aliare.
I don't know how he found a seam on that defense right there, splitting the double. Look at their dribble drive. Driving against Collado and Mabula.
At number 2.
The paint. The block! Sent back to the front zone. Juan Curva onto the first break layup. The two veterans coming up clutch.
And the top play of the week.
Has it led here in the second half. Danieleta. Goes to Helter Brand. 6 seconds on their shot clock. Long three-pointer by JJ! Oh! Bucket! JJ Helter Brand! Big time shot to put them up by 4. 94-90.
That's a wrap for our top 10 plays of the week. Stay tuned for more basketball brilliance. And until next time, keep the hoop spirit alive.
Watch Cabinet at Work every Monday for PM on IBC.
Cabinet at Work, tuwing Lunes, ika-apat ng hapon sa IBC 13.
At the half, we're tied at 40. Juan Munti and San Pedro Pablo Escobets figuring on this very tightly contested matchup. Try and get outside of that middle card. Look at some highlights during our first two quarters where Juan Munti dominated pretty much that first 10 minutes. But San Pedro able to make their adjustments, making it difficult naman para sa Juan Munti to have a similar output that they had in that first quarter behind the likes of Liagas, Javier, and their inside onslaught.
It was the contributions from Ingles and Balbuena that really made the difference back in the first quarter. I mean, they were able to score 30 big points, but it was the defense naman para dito sa panig ng San Pedro that really held down itong Juan Munti to just 10 points. And we take a look at the numbers. 42% para dito sa Juan Munti and 42% as well for San Pedro. Pero makikita mo yun dito, no? Yung bench points earlier back in the first, talagang nangunguna itong Juan Munti, but San Pedro, their bench really stepped up, especially in the second quarter to tie this game to 40.
A the end of that first nga, it was 17-5 bench points in favor of Juan Monte. Hindi naman nagpahuli itong bench mob ng San Pedro in order to make it a ball game after that 5-point lead heading into the second quarter. Natabla na nga nila at 40. And, take a look at some key performers for both of these teams. Karangian para dito sa San Pedro, and sa kabila naman nga, couple of players leading the way as well in the scoring column, talking about Ingles para sa Juan Monte.
We talked about itong si Karangian. He's a constant para sa kanyang kupunan, no? He's leading the way with 7 points, and Rich Quinitaran as well together with Chris Xavier, 7 apiece. Para sa kabilang panig naman, we're missing some names there. Wala pa dito si Kantimbuhan, but James Ingles stepping up big time para sa kanyang kupunan. Yusei Koga was able to hit 2-3 pointers already, and Balbuena, one of the bench mob, no? Itong Juan Monte already with 6 points, and Harold Arboleda naman facilitating for his team and also able to score 5 points in the first half.
We did highlight heading into this game, Melo, the marquee matchup, that not just scorers, itong si John Kantimbuhan and Andrew Estrella, both of those names missing in the leading scorers for both teams.
That's true. Itong si Kantimbuhan has been slowed down by the defense of San Pedro. They're playing really physical against him, and so far he struggled to find his rhythm.
Has been quite physical. And, our officials really calling it a bit tight, allowing these players to, you know, jockey for position inside. Has been whistled for a couple of unsportsmanlike fouls against San Pedro. Has been the theme of this ball game. Kaya talagang walang ang bumibitaw rito. Tabla tayo at 40. Heading into our second half. Kantimbuhan looking inside to Masion. Another assist from Kantimbuhan. Masion with a finish.
And once again, great half-court execution mula dito sa Juan Monte. Itong si Kantimbuhan attracting that defense and finding Masion underneath for that easy layup.
Monte goes to Santos. Turn around. Jumper goes. Smooth stroke coming from Santos.
Finally, a basket mula dito kay Santos. Ano, earlier, back in the first half, he was really forced to play tough defense, and right now, getting his touch from the mid-range.
Front line of San Pedro. Talagang yun yung nagiging sagot din nila dito sa bench mob naman nga ng Juan Monte. Tinatapatan nila yung production coming off the bench here. Kantimbuhan still unable to get that basket to go. Monte goes to Santos. He will try from three. That won't go. Arboleda corrals the rebound. And he will run it once again para sa Juan Monte. Kick out to Koga from the corner. Won't go. Masion, offensive rebound. TP hit. Can't get that basket. Agawa ng bola, Australia will come up with it. Goes to Santos. 4 points so far here in the third.
So far, this is a great start for San Pedro offensively. They've been quick in attacking that basket. And ang maganda ngayon dito, they're really battling it out on the rebounding department.
Now a 2-point lead para sa Pablo Escobet, 44-42. Close to 2 minutes gone by here in the third. Koga finds Masion underneath, another bucket. Masion has been the scorer here para sa Juan Monte. Samantalang ito naman sa San Pedro has been Santos, he's a big man.
Well, they're really finding itong si Masion right now, ano?
Santos feeling it. Turns it over. Stolen by Kantimbuhan. Apreco trailing it. Ooh. Has been quite the game for Kantimbuhan. Yung tempo niya, hindi niya talaga mahanap, eh. Melo.
And the case also of a poor spacing para dito sa Juan Monte. Ano? Not much, kumbaga, driving lane that time. Kaya nailang din itong si Kantimbuhan.
You can see it on his face, body language. And talagang may frustration. Dahil alam niya naman kung anong kaya niyang gawin. But he can't quite executed offensively, at least so far. Australia backing down. Koga scoops it up and in.
What a shot mula dito kay Andoy Estrella. Yan yung mga tinatawag na kili-kili shot.
Bursa made famous by the flying A. I wish I had that in my arsenal. 2-point lead para sa San Pedro, 46-44. Under 7 minutes left in the third. Hand off to Kantimbuhan. 5 seconds to shoot. Steps back. Three-pointer short.
And I like the coverage na binibigay itong San Pedro na switching everything on Cantimbuhan.
As Monte finds Karangian.
Transition defense starting to become a suspect para dito sa Juan Monti. Nobody tracking down itong kanilang weak side and Karangian just taking advantage of that.
The momentum built here by San Pedro leading by 4, 48 to 44 as Koga dials it from downtown. It's a one-point lead para sa San Pedro.
And a much-needed three-pointer for Juan Monti. Ryusei Koga, medyo pamatay-sunog oh, yung ginawa niya three-pointer that time.
Koga now has 9. Estrella, two-man game with Apreku. Goes to Santos, they swing it to Monte. Against Arboleda, will lose that basketball to Machon. Looking ahead, a bit too high para kay Ryusei Koga.
Nobody there to be an outlet pass para dito sa Juan Monti. Itong si Machon was forced to give that long pass to Ryusei Koga.
Meanwhile, let's hear once again from Jess Constantino. Jess?
Hi, Min Melo. During the halftime break, Coach Nel pointed out the 30 points na binigay nila sa Juan Monti. That 30 points game gave daw their opponent confidence. Buti nilang daw ay na-stop na nila ito nung second quarter. For the second half nga daw, alam ni Coach Nel na may ibibigay pa itong San Pedro Pablo Escobet ng magandang performance. Kailangan daw nilang maging mas aggressive on both ends of the court. For Juan Monti naman, Coach Vince instructed the team to communicate properly dahil nga daw miscommunication yung naging problema nila nung first half. Jaime and Melo.
Thank you, Jess. As a play is stopped, hand check foul will be called here against Karangian trying to stop that attack from Ryusei Koga. A couple of things that you would want to react on the report by Jess, Melo.
Well, that's on a coaching standpoint, ano, talagang masakit eh, every time you give up 30 points in a quarter. And tingnan muna natin dito ngayon, the biggest lead para sa Juan Monti is 7 and para naman sa San Pedro is a 5. So that's a testament to the quality of the ball game we're having here. Wala talagang gustong bumitaw and maganda nga no, yung naging response ng kupunan ni Coach Nel in the second quarter when they held down itong Juan Monti to just 10 points. A question right now here in the second half, eh, who wants it more?
Who wants it more indeed? And yung composure nga that you pointed out earlier, Melo, for both these teams, this type of ball game. Koga able to get that three-pointer. Rebound battle. Bodies on the floor. Arboleda gets it to Cantimbuhan. Ooh, blocked by Santos. Ganda basa talaga nila dito kay Cantimbuhan throughout the game so far.
It's been a long night so far para dito kay John Cantimbuhan. But if you're a scorer, it's only a matter of seeing your first shot go in and I'm sure he will make up for lost time.
Is that a bit of good news if ikaw ay isang Juan Monti fan, Melo? Hindi pa gumagana ang yung key player in Cantimbuhan na si Machon with that follow-up basket. Really picking it up in the absence nga of offense coming from Cantimbuhan so far.
And they're compensating that that point production they're missing by really being aggressive. And Machon giving them that second chance opportunity. At ito ngayon, si Cantimbuhan is forced to work on the defensive end. But let's take a look at this drive from Ryusei Koga. And Machon was there to get that second chance opportunity against 4 black shirts. Nakita mo naman to the delight of this crowd.
And celebrating each and every basket as Estrella answers on the other end. Bringing back the lead to San Pedro, 50-49.
Scorers will always find a way to put that ball in the hoop. And si Andoy Estrella, he just needed that slight opening to get that ball to go in.
7 so far para kay Estrella. Short stab, Sarip, that won't work. Santos secures that rebound. Karangian looking to attack two white shirts, drops it off to Apreku, gets the ball back. Apreku, Karangian running that break perfectly.
And Karangian, usually the guy dishing off the assists, that time around, itong si Apreku rewarding him, binalik sa kanya, hindi naman niya pinahiya itong si Felix.
52-49 now. Three-point advantage for the Black Shirts. Cantimbuhan still unable to get that basket, but Machon right there once again.
But we mentioned about controlling your emotion. After that basket, itong si Machon looked at our game officials asking for that foul. Ang masakit dito, eh natawagan siya ng technical foul.
We've been playing real well. Talking about it, si Machon, no? Close to double digits so far with 9. Has been carrying it, especially here in the third quarter. Try to keep a step.
And we saw there, itong si Harold Arboleda talking Tumasyon, tingnan muna natin ulit to. He was able to get that rebound, score another basket underneath. Was looking for that foul. Ito, si Koga, pinipigilan na siya. Alam na nila kung anong mangyayari.
53-51. 2-point lead para sa San Pedro. Estrella can't get that jumper to go. 3-20 remaining here in our third quarter. Arboleda kicks it out. Koga still 10 to work with. Swings it to Kantimbuhan. Takes a look at the clock. Still 4 seconds. His layup won't work but is clipped. And will head to the line where he just might get some rhythm to his offense.
As we take a look at this drive from Jan Kantimbuhan, scanning the floor, getting that foul, and kita mo naman doon, he really wanted that call back in the first half, but all is not lost for him. He still has 3 minutes left here in the third, and the full quarter ahead of him to make up nga doon sa kanyang lost production.
Sabi mo, mga scorers, talagang they will find a way. Although missing on that first free throw. See if he's able to adjust on the second. Still unable to get some points up for his team. Sabi mo nga, has been quite that type of evening. Kantimbuhan will miss once again. Looking for a foul, none given. Ingles goes to para to Kantimbuhan. Will miss on that layup. Wasarif fighting for it. Ball is loose. And it will stay with Juan Munti.
And a lot of action in that last sequence. Ito muna si Balbuena will get in the game. He'll be replacing itong si Kantimbuhan. But you gotta love the leadership nitong si Harold Arboleda. No, he knows that their best scorer is struggling right now. And as he was going back to the bench, I'm sure itong si Harold is giving him some words of motivation.
Alam nila, kailangan nga nila talaga itong si Kantimbuhan. In this game, as Arboleda drops it off to Sarip, to Ingles rather. Their top scorer so far is Ingles in that first half, providing that impact off the bench. Looking to do the same here, entering the third.
Ang maganda ngayon dito sa Juan Munti, they're not settling for outside shots. They're really attacking the paint and inviting itong San Pedro to a duel in that shaded area. And makita natin nga, despite San Pedro being the taller team, pantay tayo sa production in terms of points in the paint at 24 right now.
2.5 left in our third quarter. 53-52 San Pedro holding on to this 1-point lead. Go to Estrella to the block. Santos 6 to shoot. Estrella attacks, hangs in the air, short on that attempt. Arboleda hounded by two black shirts, releases it to Jimenez. Pull it back. Jimenez thought about the three. Resets to Ingles. Spins against Apreku. Hands it off to Jimenez. Bringing out the goggles.
You gotta love that. Mula dito kay Ingles. Early on, he was the one doing the damage and scoring. But right now, setting up Paolo Jimenez for that beautiful play.
Juan Munti takes the lead back. 54-53. Karangian. Hangs. Blocked inside by Sarip. Jimenez gets it to Balbuena. Hustle for both these teams, showing us how important this game is para sa parehong koponan. Slow it down once again. Just 8 seconds to work with. Ingles against Apreku. Goes behind the back. PP hit. Blocked by Apreku. Well read. Santos looking ahead to Karangian. Finishes with a lefty.
And Karangian, as always, a great finisher in the open court against two guys right there. Not a problem for him.
Advantage back to the San Pedro. Pablo Escobedo. It's 55-54. Less than a minute left here in the third.
Really trying to slow things down here. Not talking about Juan Munti using all the time that they need.
Sarip. Apreku na naman nasusubukan. He tries. Attacks. Blocked. But a foul will be called here. Ganda na nung basa ni Apreku, but the help defense from Santos might be the culprit. Nope, it would be a preco that will be whistled for this personal.
That's a bailout para dito sa Juan Montino. The shot clock was already almost over.
Some substitutions here. Well, much needed stop from game. Kailangan natin. Has been up and down for the past few minutes. Chris Xavier made a great impact para sa San Pedro in that first half.
That's true.
Had to nurse those two fouls nga. Kaya siya maagang naupo. And very fresh heading into the last 37.8 of this third.
Ito ngayon, Juan Munti still has two fouls to give. No? I'm sure they're gonna use that and not allow itong San Pedro to have a good look.
Sarip, short on that first. Able to tie this ball game just yet. Second rattles out. 1-point lead pa rin being held here by San Pedro. Homo back in the ball game. Mangahas, inigot nila. Javier for three. Rattles out. Kiminales. Looking for a friend. Finds Arboleda. Shot clock is off. They could hold for the last shot if they wish to. Sarip gets reminded by his bench. They reset to Ingles. Arboleda. 5 seconds to Ingles. Wide open for three. Gets that three-pointer to go. Waxing hot is Ingles. Now with 14. As the Juan Munti crowd goes wild, and they will get this two-point lead heading into the fourth quarter. Take a look at that Ingles three-pointer against that chase down from Javier. Still able to convert. More importantly, give Juan Munti this two-point lead heading into our last quarter.
The BSL President's Cup 2024 is brought to you by Dumper Party List, C Prime Business Financing Corporation, Converge FiberX, supported by Kalos PH Sportswear, MDC Sports, Finn Cotton,
Healthy and Pure, official hydration partner, Top Cop Gentleman's Grooming, Prepare for Battle, Your Healthy Life, Japanese Style Clinic,
media partners, Fiber TV, Blast TV, and Bola.TV.
Live at IBC 13.
Moments before we begin our payoff period. It's the second of a triple header, and what a ball game it has been. I'm Mendy Arcel here with Coach Melo Navarro alongside Jess Constantino, bringing you this matchup between Juan Munti and San Pedro. Pablo Escobets, just 2 points separating these teams, and it has been the theme for our first three quarters, Melo. Ang akala mo bibitaw na yung isa, but the other takes the lead back, and vice versa. And just 2 points separating them, 57-55, heading into the fourth quarter.
It's all about making the necessary adjustments for both these teams. So back in the first, it was the bench of Juan Munti. Na-counter yan itong San Pedro. And ngayon naman, in the third, Juan Munti choosing to slow things down, going to their half-court execution. And so far, they've been brilliant in doing that.
At ang yung pasensya, literally, paying off here for the white shirt. Stolen by Ingles. 4-on-3. Have the numbers. Looking for Arboleda inside. Loses the leather. Recovers to Balbuena. Long on that three. Did hit a couple in the first half. Talking about itong si Balbuena. Konting gigil siguro. Long on that three-pointer. Would have extended this lead to 5. Mangahas. Directing the traffic here para sa San Pedro. Limitaran back in the ballgame as well para sa Pablo Escobets. He's the guy they have been looking for quite a lot. As we look at the points per quarter here, a bit of a slowdown in the second and third, Melo.
Yeah, it was a downtrend no, for both our teams. But yun nga, yung itong Juan Munti was able to come alive once again in the third. That's why they're up in this game.
Speaking of scoring, their leader, Harold Arboleda, showing us the way, finishing despite the contact. Let's take another look.
Harold Arboleda using that upper body strength. Tina naman natin to, using his handles, absorbing the contact, finishing despite a lot of physicality in that play, and that's Harold Arboleda for you.
Describe this game in the first quarter. Binigyan na naman tayo ng isang example of how versatile Harold Arboleda has been. And yung game niya na nag-evolve. Talagang leading the break. Doesn't have to find a guard. Takes it all the way using his size. Gets that finish and extending this lead now to 5-60 to 55. Javier will try once again. Gets that three-pointer to go. Dikit na naman ang San Pedro dito.
And we know that Chris has that shot. Ano, Harold Arboleda inviting him to take it. And sabi ni Chris, nakalimutan mo yata na meron ako niyan.
60-58. Still a two-point advantage para sa Juan Monti. Go to Koga. Arboleda now. He will try from three. Too strong. Rebound from Ginitaran. Tumangahas. Gets the ball back. Drives baseline. May ipit. But still finds a way.
That's a great move mula ko kay Rich Ginitaran. I thought that was already great defense from Ingles, stopping him on that baseline. But the talent and skill level itong si Rich is really in full display here.
Guess what, Melo? We're tied once again at 60. Koga. Seven to shoot. Trying to escape the defense of Javier. He will pull up from three. Way off. But the putback from Ingles. Out rebounding Parillagas in that instance.
So that has been the story para dito sa Juan Monti. No? Yung kanilang hustle and the effort to get those second chance opportunities really paying off in this game. Even the guards crashing the boards for them.
What a game so far. Para nga dito kay Ingles.
And John Cantimbuhan, averaging 17 points, 6.4 assists tonight, has really struggled. Only scoring 4 points, dishing out 2 assists. But sabi nga natin, he may be struggling, but he's still the leader of this team. And if you're San Pedro, you cannot be complacent here.
Missing on that three. Ingles will be whistled for that foul, trying to come up with that steal. That would be team foul number one pa lamang.
And this time around, itong Juan Monti, no, will go for that half-court defense of theirs. Problema ngayon dito, merong mismatch against itong si Javier and Harold Arboleda.
Mangahas, he will try for three. Off, Liagas, offensive rebound. Chance to reset if you are San Pedro. Go back to Javier. Arboleda now sticking to him. Mangahas again. Four to work with. Gets the ball back top of the key. Shot clock was winding down. Had to put that up. Homo saves it to the wrong shirt in Kiminales.
Ito ngayon, a chance for Juan Monti to add on this lead.
Timbuhan once again. Still can't buy a basket. Mangahas to Liagas. Ooh, finger roll, bit too strong. Kiminales looking ahead to Harold Arboleda. Gets the ball back. Kiminales short on his layup. Arboleda gets the bump. Able to get that finish. Have to earn it from the line.
That's just the brilliance of Harold Arboleda. It was one against three. Waited for Paolo Kiminales. And kita mo naman siya pa rin ang nakakuha ng rebound dun. It's the habit that he was able to build all throughout yung kanyang playing career. No, talagang always going for the 50-50 balls. And that's really the value that he could bring to the table if you're playing against and ito kay Harold Arboleda.
We pointed out several times Harold Arboleda, you know, speaking to Cantimbuhan earlier, speaking to his teammates, trying to, you know, keep them focused. Wag mawala na kumpiyansa despite their struggles. Not just giving that vocal leadership, but showing them how it's done.
Oo, totoo yan. And alam naman nga natin, it's one thing to say the right words. And it's another if you're really showing it. And itong man si Andoy Estrella, 13.8 points average, 5.4 assists right now. He has 8 and 2. So yung ating marquee matchup, ano? Medyo having a long night. And alam naman natin, that's expected because late in the season, late in the tournament, nakafocus na sa kanila yung mga defensive schemes. So it's a matter of them playing decoy nga and adjusting to what's being given to them.
Could it label them as not just scorers? Maybe the scoring really won't be the weapon of choice for Estrella and Cantimbuhan in this matchup. Trying to elude the defense of Ingles, goes to Ginitaran. It's a second to shoot. A shot clock expires para sa Pablo Escobets. Will be a turnover nonetheless. It's Arboleda down on the floor here.
And you saw there na itong si Cantimbuhan. He may be struggling on offense, but that time around was able to force that stop against Rich Ginitaran.
The PSL President's Cup 2024 is brought to you by Dumper Party List, C Prime Business Financing Corporation, Converge FiberX, supported by Kalos PH Sportswear, MDC Sports, Finn Cotton,
Healthy and Pure, official hydration partner, Top Cop Gentleman's Grooming. Prepare for battle, your healthy life, Japanese Style Clinic.
Media partners, Fiber TV, Blast TV, and Bola.TV.
Live at IBC 13.
5:50 remaining in this matchup between Juan Munti and San Pedro. A four-point lead for the White Shirts. Di pa rin tayo sa Paco Arena in Manila, enjoying the second of a triple header. Tid sa atin ng Pilipinas Super League. And itong four-point lead na to, Coach Melo, it seems like parang ang dami na for this type of ball game that we've had so far.
Well, tightly contested ball game we're seeing here. Medyo na any lead that you could have is really something that you're gonna be happy with. Dahil alam nga natin, no, talagang bakbakan, ipalitan ng kalamangan. In fact, we already had about 14 lead changes here. So that's a testament to the quality of game we're having.
Jimenez makes a move on the baseline. Underneath, blocked by Javier. Leading the break is Ginitaran. Finds Estrella for the finish.
Another fast break attack para dito sa San Pedro. And that time around, it was Rich Ginitaran leading the break for them. Pushing it off to Andoy Estrella for that lay-in.
Slowly but surely, Estrella getting his output now with 10. Koga stepping back. Gets that jumper to go.
That's what you love para dito kay Ryusei Koga. He's really a scorer. And pag binigyan mo ng konting butas, he will really take advantage.
Javier, he will try once again. Same spot, same result. Talaga namang pinapakita that Chris Javier, if hindi mo talaga siya dinikitan, he will make you pay.
And it's because he has a smaller defender on him. That's Harold Arboleda. Kaya naman talaga he could see that ring from that spot.
Down to a one-point lead para sa Juan Munti. Arboleda from the K. Matatapikan ni Estrella. As Cantimbuhan to bait. Pulls up, drops it off to Chris Javier. An assist this time from Andoy Estrella.
You know, the patience mula dito kay Andoy. Once again, rewarding itong si Chris Javier who does that rim run job. And wala na naman yung transition defense itong Juan Munti.
San Pedro will take the lead back. 67-66. 4:08 left in this game. Cantimbuhan makes his move. Off the glass, short. Jimenez trying to fight for that offensive rebound. They will lose it to Karangian. Has a 2-on-2. Goes to Estrella. Shadowed by Ingles. Makes his move. Tapped by Ingles. But a foul will be whistled against him. Estrella will head to the line for two.
Well, that's really the challenge, especially when you're playing transition defense. Because normally, nagiging cross-match yan, you know. And in that confusion, inapahampas nga itong si Ingles.
Meanwhile, let's take it a bit of a break through Jess Constantino with a report.
Hi, me and Melo. Break muna tayo sa basketball ng konti. Kilala natin itong si Andoy Estrella. Alam nyo ba, na kung hindi daw siya basketball player, siguro daw ay teacher na siya ngayon dahil he finished Bachelor of Science major in PE from Mapua. Kaya nga daw, for now, he is conducting basketball clinics muna sa lugar nila in Rizal. Outside of basketball, alam nyo bang meron din siyang online selling business as an adjunct source of income na sinimulan niya noong pandemya. Hi, me and Melo.
Beautiful story shared there by Jess Constantino that Andoy Estrella could be a teacher. I wouldn't mind picking up a few things from Andoy Estrella and his clinics.
And if you're Andoy, no, he really has a lot to share sa kanyang mga estudyante.
Javier, high up for that board of that Machon miss. Two-point lead pa para sa San Pedro. Just 3:25 left in this game. Estrella, tingnan natin, slowly picking up his rhythm. Tries from outside, unable to get that three-pointer. Apreco An offensive rebound back to Estrella. Floater is good.
And this time around, pagkakataon naman itong San Pedro to score off of those second chance opportunities and di sinasayang itong si Yandoy.
Estrella now with 12. Koga. Goes cross-court to Ingles. Backs down Estrella. Turn around off the glass. Trying to stay with San Pedro is James Ingles and Juan Munti. Trailing by 2, 70-68. So take another look at that move. Tamang pihit lang para kay James Ingles. 70-68, bante pa rin ang San Pedro.
The PSL President's Cup 2024 is brought to you by Dumper Party List, C Prime Business Financing Corporation, Converge FiberX, supported by Kalos PH Sportswear, MDC Sports, Finn Cotton.
Healthy and Pure, official hydration partner, Top Cop Gentleman's Grooming. Prepare for battle, your healthy life, Japanese Style Clinic.
Media partners, Fiber TV, Blast TV, and Bola.TV.
Live at IBC 13.
With just 2:56 remaining in this game, 2-point lead lamang para sa San Pedro Pablo Escobets. Several lead changes, several deadlocks, Melo, and I'm pretty sure we're in for a tight finish.
That's true, and still anybody's ball game. Itong ating natutunghayan dito. Again, we talked about it in the first quarter. It's all about composure and execution na makikita natin. We'll be able to do that in the remainder of this game.
Estrella goes to Ginitaran. Javier, court 6 in this quarter. Makes his move against Arboleda. Powers his way through.
Chris Javier faking that handoff, taking it to the post, and really taking matters into his own hands already at 17 in this game.
Creating a 4-point cushion para sa Pablo Escobets. Santimbuhan goes to Arboleda. Gets the ball back against Apreku. Balik kay Arboleda. It's 5 to shoot now. Bibitin. Bit wayward. Able to convert on that possession is Juan Munti. San Pedro looking to extend this 4-point advantage. Close to 2 minutes remaining in this game. Karangian goes to Estrella. Makes his move. Another up and under. Won't work. Ingles with a board.
Kind of forced the situation right there. Talking about tong si Yandoy, Estrella.
Ingles kicks it out. Cantimbuhan for 3. Still can't get that 3-pointer to go. It's a jump ball whistled here by our officials. Unsure. Sino ang last touch?
And under the 2 minutes, this is going to be a review. Pero you would sense, no, the anticipation. As itong si Cantimbuhan was going for that shot. It was wide open. Kina natin to. Rebounding battle. Oh, from that angle, it's hard to judge, no? Dahil halos sabay na hawakan.
It was a jump ball initially whistled by our officials. It's going back to the performance of John Cantimbuhan so far, Melo, no? As ating poging writer, Joseph Joel Parcon, is pointing out. Previous game nila against Cam Norte Warriors, which they did win by 1. 2 points lamang. Ito si Cantimbuhan Jr., but he had 14 assists. So still making that type of impact. So, gusto nga nating, despite those struggles, maybe he's able to still find his teammate, especially with the last minute and 37, given the struggles that he had throughout the ballgame.
So far, yung pinapakita na ngayon in this game is not being reflected on the stat sheet, but he's doing the intangibles para sa kanyang kupunan. Earlier, nagkaroon nga siya ng magandang stop mo against Rich Ginitaran as he was able to tap that ball out. So those small things na talaga namang trying to compensate nga for that offensive production that they're missing from him. And that's a sign of a good player, no? So he's showing us that he's a two-way player.
Call stands. And, even after the review, sabi mo nga, Melo, very hard to determine.
Oo eh. Let's take a look at that again. Sabay na sabay. And the thing about it, hindi nagbago yung direction and trajectory ng bola. Kaya mahirap talaga ma-determine.
So it would be a jump ball. Mashon and Apreku. Figuring in our center court. Jimenez will check back in para sa Juan Munti. He will replace Machon.
But I don't think they could replace him kasi siya yung involved doon sa jump ball situation.
Yep, it was Machon and Karangian battling for that loose ball earlier. So sila nga. Yeah, clearly an advantage here para kay Machon. Taps it to the wrong jersey. And Chris Javier, napangiti na lang si Chris Javier.
And they're gonna slow things down here.
Up by 4 is San Pedro, 72-68. Javier, 7 to shoot now, Karangian. Attacks. Dipsy-Doo won't work. Battle for the board. It's a loose ball foul will be whistled here against Juan Munti. James Inglis is the culprit.
He was trying to chase down that long rebound, then in the process, eh, medyo napahawi dito kay Andoy Estrella. But good thing, they're not yet in the penalty. Talking about itong Juan Munti. So you can look at that again. Almost everything but the shot. At ito nga yun, no? Ayun eh. Na-veterano.
And the official was right there. Immediately whistled for that foul. A minute and 12 remaining. Shot clock will reset to 14 para sa San Pedro. Estrella goes to Javier. Back to Estrella. Sarip, eye to eye with him. Use the prickly pick. Finds Javier. Two to shoot now. Ooh, slow-mo move. Unable to convert, but a prickly there to clean it up. Now a 6-point lead para sa Pablo Escobets.
That was such a sequence para dito sa San Pedro. Chris Javier with that beautiful move. Missed everything there. But once again, Apreco stepping up, getting that rebound and scoring para sa kanyang kupunan, which prompts a timeout for Juan Munti.
The BSL President's Cup 2024 is brought to you by Dumper Party List, C Prime Business Financing Corporation, Converge FiberX, supported by Kalos PH Sportswear, MDC Sports, Finn Cotton,
Healthy and Pure, official hydration partner, Top Cop Gentleman's Grooming, prepare for battle, your healthy life, Japanese Style Clinic,
media partners, Fiber TV, Blast TV, and Bola.TV,
live at IBC 13.
55.8 seconds remaining in this ball game. San Pedro, Pablo Escobets able to create this cushion, 74-68 against Juan Munti. After that basket nga from Felix Apreco, that defensive rebound, very important for Juan Munti to secure, Melo. Hindi nga lang nila nakuha against the league leading rebounder in Felix Apreco.
And speaking of something important, this possession is a must score para dito sa Juan Munti.
Inglis will pull up for three. Gets the three-pointer to go. Much needed para sa Juan Munti. Just a few seconds off that clock. Back to one possession ball game.
What a shot mga dito kay Inglis.
Pressure put up here by Juan Munti. No need to foul if you are the white shirts. Estrella holding on to this basketball against Koga. Down to 7 seconds. Makes a move. Drops it off to Karangian. Takes it on the other side. And will be fouled. As Juan Munti visibly displeased with that whistle. Parang bailout na yun. The shot clock was winding down. Karangian had to put that up.
Everybody on the bench up on their feet right now. That was a... Andoy Estrella attacking to the right side. At the last second, doon nahanap itong siya Karangian underneath and Karangian went for that Dipsy-Doo. What a sequence.
Our officials will take another look. Estrella, that patience to find Karangian. Inglis challenged that reverse layup. Juan Munti seeing that replay as well here in our big screen sa ating Paco Arena. still making a case for a foul to not have been called. Give them an opportunity sana to...
No. Mabigat yun eh. Because they really wanted that defensive stop because it's just a one-possession ball game. And if it's gonna be two free throws, mag-extend to a two-possession game. And with 27.3 seconds remaining, medyo hindi magandang sitwasyon yun for Juan Munti because kaya naman talaga ngayon. They're really getting for that challenge, but the call stays.
Confirmed nga by our officials, Ingles. Will be whistled for that personal. Call stands after that review. So Karangian has a couple of opportunities to extend this lead to a two-possession ball game. Let's have another look at that move.
Ayun, you know, you could argue that the left hand of Ingles. Karangian, as always, a steady presence for them, knocking down that first free throw, extending this game to a two-possession ball game.
That's the more important free throw. Huh? Releases a lot of pressure for the second. Misses it badly. All is not lost if you are Juan Munti here. 27.3 seconds. We saw earlier they were able to convert a three-pointer very quickly off James Ingles. And they will see what they can draw up. The last 27.3 seconds, still trailing by four, is Juan Munti.
The BSL President's Cup 2024 is brought to you by Dumper Party List, C Prime Business Financing Corporation, Converge FiberX, supported by Kalos PH Sportswear, MDC Sports, Finn Cotton,
Healthy and Pure, official hydration partner, Top Cop Gentleman's Grooming, prepare for battle, your healthy life, Japanese Style Clinic,
media partners, Fiber TV, Blast TV, and Bola.TV.
Live at IBC 13.
27.3 seconds remaining in the ball game, 75-71. 4-point lead pa rin para sa San Pedro Pablo Escobets. Bola ng Juan Munti dito, Melo. It is a two-possession ball game. Have a look at where these two teams stand at the moment. 7-4 para sa Juan Munti and San Pedro at 6-5. We were pointing out all throughout the ballgame how important this ballgame is for both these squads and try and get out of that middle cellar. And so far, San Pedro has kind of one foot in terms of securing this victory.
Earlier, they were able to score a quick three-pointer, but right now, really not needed. Kahit a quick two, pwede na.
Criminales goes to Kantimbuhan against Apregu. Strong to the hoop! Called from behind, we'll have to instead get those points from the line.
That, however, is a good decision para to kay Kantimbuhan. Opted to take that ball strong to the hoop. And if he's going to be able to knock down two free throws here, they still have a great chance.
Kantimbuhan, despite his struggles in this ball game, an opportunity to bring his team closer, short on the first. Would still be able to make this a one-possession ball game with a conversion. They could play the foul game. Second free throw, won't get the bounce. Rebound battle, Arboleda gets the ball back. Kantimbuhan will try from outside. Still can't get a three-pointer. Karangian will secure that rebound. Will lose the basketball. Koga fighting it with Ginitaran. And another jump ball will be called here with 7.8 seconds remaining.
And itong Juan Muntino had all the chances there. Missing two free throws. Getting that ball back for a three-point attempt. And that has been the story of the game lang. Talagang... yung struggles nga itong si John Kantimbuhan. And so far, you would see, you know, that he really wants to win this ball game. He wants to contribute, but as a player, dumarating lang talaga. There are days like this, and what an unfortunate time for it to come.
So our officials trying to sort things out. Initial call was a jump ball between Ginitaran and Koga. Chris Xavier have been displeased kasi Ginitaran was holding on to his above his left eye, might have received some inadvertent contact. in that loose ball battle. 7.8 remaining. 75-71 tayo dito. 4-point lead being protected by San Pedro. Wala nang timeout on Juan Munti, Coach Melo. Really making it a lot more difficult.
And they're gonna need to get this possession. Because we could expect itong San Pedro to really waste as much time as they can once they have that ball.
Officials, maybe just trying to figure out who should be figuring out on this jump ball. From the replay, it appeared to be Yusei Koga and Ginitaran. Should be jumping it out on center court.
Ito, looks like things are already in order.
And yun na nga, Koga and Ginitaran. Advantage here for Ginitaran, obviously, height-wise. But we've seen how that worked for Juan Munti. Marboleda recovers. Makes his move. Goes to James Inglis.
And he was fouled. Attempting a three-pointer. Tingnan natin.
That's the case that they're trying to make. But it was a foul on the floor. Sabi nga ng ating officials. Not buying that explanation from James Inglis. 3.8 remaining. Need a quick trigger. Your Juan Munti. Inglis for three. That short as time will run out. And the San Pedro, Pablo Escobets will hold on to this 4-point victory, 75-71 against Juan Munti.
It was all about execution and composure in the end game. And itong ng San Pedro was able to prove that they are the one who could execute that. And the turning point, I believe, was that rebound mula dito kay Felix Apreku. Let's take a look at this move mula kay Andoy Estrella scooping that shot. Sabi nga natin, flying A, kili-kili shot ang binitawan itong si Andoy Estrella.
That was our dumper super move of the game, courtesy of Andoy Estrella. He did pick up his offense right when they needed it most. And that proved to be the difference. Secure this victory nga para sa San Pedro, Pablo Escobet, 75-71. But despite that, our super player of the game, the impact that Chris Xavier made dito para sa San Pedro, especially in that fourth quarter, he did sit out for quite a bit dahil nga maaga siya nga nagka-two fouls. But when he returned in the ball game, Melo, talaga namang capitalized on those mismatches.
Totoo yan. Si Chris Xavier really took charge in that most important part of the game. Kaya naman siya talaga ang ating napili.
And he is with Jess Constantino for our super player of the game.
Hello, kasama ko ang ating Carlos PH super player of the game, Chris Xavier, of course, from San Pedro, Pablo Escobet. Chris, ngayon, top 8 kayo. Assessing your game today, ano pa sa tingin mo yung kailangan yung i-improve to secure that spot?
Well, first of all, nagpapasalamat po sa San Pedro, Pablo Escobet, for giving me the opportunity to play again. Para sa akin, we just have to play as a team. And yun nga, sinasabi ni Coach Nel sa amin, we have to play defense talaga. Kasi yun yung puhunan namin, defense. So, yun lang po.
Now, Chris, batiin mo naman yung mga fans and supporters ng inyong team.
Well, unang-una, I would like to greet ang tumulong sa amin na Mayor Art Mercado, San Pedro, and kay Boss Pablo, kay Boss Pau, Boss James, at saka sa mga bumubuo ng San Pedro, Pablo Escobet. And to all the fans ng San Pedro, sana supportahan nyo kami sa mga upcoming games namin. Yun lang. Thank you.
Thank you, Chris, and congratulations again to San Pedro, Pablo Escobet. Back to you, Jaime and Melo, to close.
Thank you, Jess, and congratulations again, Chris Xavier, our super player of the game, securing this victory para sa San Pedro, Pablo Escobet. And that would be it for our second game of this evening. One more coming right up. Strong group Blazers going up against the San Juan Kings. Yan lamang po kayo, magbabalik pa po ang inyong Pilipinas Super League. Dito, Pinoy ang bida.